Welcome back, everyone. It is now time for Alligator Bioscience and CEO Søren Bregenholt. A warm welcome. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you, David. Yes. Just before we start, a brief disclaimer. So, as I'm new in the Swedish biotech community, I thought it would be prudent to introduce myself before we start. So, I'm Søren Bregenholt. I have spent the last 20 years in pharma and biotech industry in companies like Symphogen, Novo Nordisk, where I got my biotech and corporate education, and most recently as a CEO of a private UK-based biotech company. Alligator management, you also see on this slide, seasoned and experienced drug developers like Malin, our Chief Operating Officer, our CSO, Peter Ellmark, who is sort of instrumental in our understanding of CD40 biology and our technology, our Chief Business Officer, Gail Mills, who operates out of the U.S. and, by the way, was instrumental in the Servier acquisition of Symphogen a couple of years ago, and finally, Marie Svensson, our CFO, who got awarded actually the best annual report for small cap only last week. So expect high-quality communication from Alligator Bioscience. So Alligator Bioscience listed on the Nasdaq here in Stockholm. We have a best-in-class diversified pipeline of antibodies. We have a cutting-edge technology. And the company has a new management and also a relatively new board that has come together behind a strategy to really focus on the execution of our lead clinical assets, especially mitazalimab, to create value for patients and also for investors over the years to come. Together with the experienced and very committed team of approximately 45 employees, we believe that Alligator is well positioned for future growth and value creation. So what business does Alligator operate in? We operate in immune oncology, and as many of you are probably aware, immune oncology is all about increasing the body's immune system's ability to combat cancer cells. And as you can see on the illustration here, there are two sort of key cell types that Alligator address. It's the dendritic cell that sort of patrol the tumor, and the T cells that are directly responsible for killing the tumor cells and thereby controlling the cancer. Immune oncology has revolutionized cancer treatments over the last decade. However, still only 15%, in some instances, maybe 25% of the patients get durable responses from the treatments that they receive. Hence, so-called combination treatment, where chemotherapy and biological drugs or biological drugs on biological drugs are combined, has become mainstay. The whole immune oncology market continues to grow approximately 10% year on year, and Alligator plays in that niche in what we call our winning strategy. And we do that on a number of features. So first of all, our molecules are designed, they are second-generation agonistic antibodies, activating key immune pathways on dendritic cells and T cells that are complementary to the molecules that are currently used in cancer treatments today. Secondly, we design our molecules in a way so they have optimal efficacy and safety ratio, allowing them to add efficacy in combination with other molecules without adding unwanted safety concerns on top of the combination treatments. So these two features together make our drugs the perfect combination agent for existing standard of care, whether that is chemotherapy or immune oncology drugs such as checkpoint inhibitors. And finally, we develop our molecules in indications with high unmet medical need, making a difference for patients and also clearing a path for regulatory approval on the backside of positive clinical data. If we look at the pipeline, We believe it's robust. It has a number of both near and long-term value drivers. If we look at the top section, we have mitazalimab, which is our key value driver, a CD40 agonist that we have just initiated phase II clinical trials in first-line metastatic pancreatic cancer. We have 1017, which is agonistic 4-1BB, so that's a T-cell target. We are in the latter part of the phase I clinical trial with that molecule, and we have our collaboration with Aptevo around 527, a bispecific antibody, where we are in the process of filing an IND with the U.S. FDA to start the phase I trials either very late this year or early next year. We have a pipeline here with a section with near-term value inflection points. If we look at the middle section of the pipeline slide here, we have Neo-X-Prime, our third-generation immune therapy platform. It's a bispecific antibody founded in CD40 biology. We are currently developing our own molecule, which is in late-stage discovery, and we are running a project in collaboration with U.S.-based MacroGenics on a so far undisclosed targets that is a little bit further, a little bit earlier than our own proprietary program. This gives us the clicker here is not really working. That doesn't matter. Gives us an opportunity for long-term growth by building both our proprietary and a partner pipeline with this technology. Finally, in the bottom, we have a number of partner programs, and let me just focus your attention on the collaboration with Orion, a typical biotech deal where Orion are licensing our technologies. Alligator are developing antibodies, bispecific antibodies against undisclosed targets, and that deal has a total value of approximately 469 million euros, thereby creating both near-term and long-term revenue flow into the company. Let's take a closer look at the immediate value driver for Alligator, mitazalimab, our CD40 agonistic antibody with best-in-class potential. As I said, it binds on CD40 on dendritic cells, thereby making these cells much more prone and active in stimulating T-cells, thereby driving tumor immunity in the cancer patients. It's a second-generation antibody with built-in safety switches that sort of ascertain that the molecule is only active in the tumor and not elsewhere in the body. Our preclinical data, and I'll show you that in a moment, shows us that this molecule is a potential universal combinatory agent, and we intend to develop the molecule as such, and we are currently in phase II clinical trials. Here, data showing mitazalimab in combination preclinically with a number of standard of cares. On your left, you have chemotherapy, where we see a clear synergy between mitazalimab and the chemotherapy. On the left, you have in another setting a combination with a PD-1 antibody. Here again, you can see a strong synergy between the standard of care and mitazalimab. Just in the middle, we have a study using an experimental vaccine. Again, mitazalimab shows synergy with that treatment. Mitazalimab, a CD40 antibody as a universal combinatory agent with standard of care. The molecule has already been in phase I clinical trial, typical basket trial in solid tumors. What did we learn from that trial? We saw that in this very hard-to-treat patient population, last resort patients, that we still had partial responses and stable diseases for more than half a year in this difficult patient population. Importantly, we got proof of mechanism showing dose-dependent activation of both antigen-presenting cells and T-cells in the patients, and also upregulation of gene therapy or gene profiles. We saw a strong and benign safety profile and altogether the antibody behaved in humans as we expected it to do. And we believe that these data warrant the further development of mitazalimab. That's why we have just initiated Optimize 1. I'll talk more about that over the next couple of slides. And are also planning to start Optimize 2. And we are currently in the process of analyzing a number of indications to be targeted in that trial. So this slide on the left hand and the middle panel just show you the data that I described before, the dose-dependent activation of antigen-presenting cells and T cells in humans, reiterating and reinforcing the positive profile of mitazalimab. On the right hand, we are describing data from some of our peers that also in pancreatic cancer have shown that CD40 antibodies in combination with chemotherapy enhances macrophage activation, enhances T cell activation and recruitment to the tumor, and also alters the connective tissue in the tumor, making it more susceptible to immune therapy. And also clinical benefit has been illustrated in these trial. So pancreatic cancer is a hard to treat cancer. It's the seventh leading cause of death in worldwide in cancers. It's only operable in approximately 20% of the patients. Even with standard of care chemotherapy, you only see a modest effect. You have a 5-year survival rate of 10%. A median survival rate of 5 to 7 months, which is of course devastating for these patients, but in a drug development perspective, allow Alligator to read out data from Optimize 1 relatively fast. We don't see any revolutionizing treatments in the pipeline. The drug and or the indication qualifies for orphan drug indication, and we see a projected market size of approximately $5.5 billion in the next 10 to 15 years. First line treatment will of course take the majority of that market growth. So we have designed Optimize 1 in a way that gives the optimal chance for mitazalimab to show clinical benefit. It's an open label single arm phase 2 study in first line metastatic pancreatic cancer. We're going to enroll up to 67 patients in the trial. We are dosing higher than our peers, we are dosing more frequently than our peers, and we are also dosing the patients with the mitazalimab prior to the chemotherapy regime, thereby giving mitazalimab the optimal chance to show clinical benefit in the patients and also show differentiation from our competitors. And we believe that positive data in this trial will clear a path towards registration in first line for mitazalimab. The trial started actually a couple of weeks ago. We enrolled the first patient. Sites are active in Belgium and France, screening and enrolling patients. We expect to read out the first part of the trial Q1 2022. The first interim efficacy data will come towards the end of next year, and we expect to read out the full trial in the beginning of 25. Let me just shift gear here and introduce you to NeoX Prime, which is a bispecific antibody approach against building on CD40 and all the agonistic effects that we just talked about for mitazalimab. The idea with the NeoX Prime is that the other arm of the, or the other binding capacity of the molecule binds to tumor-associated antigens that are preferentially expressed on certain tumors, thereby, if I may, spoon-feeding tumor exosomes, tumor antigens, neoantigens, to the dendritic cells, allowing them in a personalized manner really stimulate the immune system in the cancer patients. And we hold great promise of NeoX Prime, both as a therapy for cancer patients, and from a corporate level, we also see it as a longer-term value driver, allowing us to build both a proprietary pipeline, build a partnered pipeline and also get revenues into the company through licensing and collaboration deals, which I believe we validated. This approach we validated by the deal with the US-based MacroGenics that we announced earlier this year. Talking about deals, let me just reiterate the three collaborations we have. We have 50-50 co-development partnerships, as I've already alluded to, both with Aptevo for 527 on the way into phase one, our discovery partnership with MacroGenics, and also our licensing and collaboration agreement with Orion. I see this both as a way for Alligator to build a pipeline in a risk and financially balanced way in the years to come, create revenue into the company through licensing, upfronts, milestones and royalties. And to me, it really validates our technology, our approach and our collaboration ability as a partner. Looking at the milestone in the upcoming years, as I said, Optimize 1, the trial is active. We expect to read out data first time Q1 next year, then an interim readout in Q4 next year. We will start Optimize 2 in the second half of 2022. And then I've not talked about the 1017 very much. We expect to wrap up the phase one trial Q1 next year, and the company will then make a strategic assessment on whether to take the molecule forward alone or most likely get a partner on board to strengthen our cash flow and also add to our development capabilities. So let me wrap up. Alligator Bioscience is operating in immuno-oncology, an indication with high unmet medical need, sustainable growth. We use our technology to generate best-in-class antibodies that are optimal combination therapies. Mitazalimab and 1017 are the sort of the key short-term value drivers in the pipeline. Our partnered approach will allow us to build the pipeline in a risk and financially balanced way in the years to come. And finally, I see NeoXprime as a future growth engine for the company. And with these words, I thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Søren, for an interesting presentation.
Thank you. It was a pleasure.
I would like to start talking about the strategy you have set. How is that? Could you point out some key issues, how it differs from the former strategy?
Yeah, I think there is a couple of subtle points, but that when you sort of put them into effect, they become very sort of prominent. We will invest significantly in mitazalimab, both expanding and accelerating phase two program. We know a lot about this molecule. We believe it's in potential. We believe in CD40 agonist in pancreatic cancer. And to sort of balance the inherent risk of drug development out, we are going to, as I said, start a second phase two trial. So that's sort of the CD40 agonism. Then building on that, investing a little bit more aggressively in NeoXprime, our longer term value driver, and giving that platform a chance for validation, you could say, bringing hopefully our proprietary molecule all the way into phase one in the very foreseeable future. And then I think we as a company, now having built that sort of CD40 story, we need to take a look at the data from 1017on how that pans out after phase one, whether that is a molecule that we need a partner with, whether it's something that we have the capacity to take forward, or whether we want to out-license it completely.
Mm-hmm. Great. And the start of the optimized phase two trial,
yeah,
that's a big milestone. Could you please elaborate on that?
But of course, it's a big milestone. I mean, as I used to say, I mean, you need to get the last patient into the trial. You first need to get the first patient into the trial. So getting that proof of concept trial started is, of course, for mitazalimab, an important milestone. And now it's really sort of up to us operationally to follow through to ensure that we deliver on the promises that I just made. And I'm absolutely convinced that the team will do that. Then for the company, I mean, Alligator's been around for 20 years, and finally getting a molecule into the intent to treat population is of course something that makes all my colleagues immensely proud and has sort of lifted the spirit in the company. I guess that is sort of one of the key milestones in drug development. So that is huge. And of course for the investors, for the patients as well.
Perfect. And looking at your collaborations, yeah. The outcome from the research collaboration with Scandion Oncology has yeah. yielded positive results. Can you explain what this means for the company?
Yeah, so it reinforces our belief in mitazalimab. So the collaboration with Scandion, if you look at it from a an Alligator point of view, was really the opportunity to test whether mitazalimab and FOLFIRINOX would also be efficacious in a cell line setting, a preclinical setting with a chemotherapy resistant cell line, because eventually that you expect that that the cancer cells become somewhat resistant. And we saw that we still had sort of efficacy and we still had the synergy. So we got that out of it as we wanted. My good colleagues at Scandion, which you'll talk to later, I think they got what they needed as well. And as we have announced, we have now sort of concluded the collaboration to sort of take those data and continue our investments in our key assets as they deserve.
Yes, yeah, quite a clear benefit.
Yeah.
So how about your new research collaboration with Orion? It both validates your approach and opens new possibilities for you. How important is collaboration for future development?
But so I think when you are a biotech company, sort of the tech part of that word sort of goes back to your technology and the need to have cutting edge technology. And our bispecific platform and underlying technology catalog is cutting edge. And that has been validated with our collaboration with Orion. I'm very excited about the target that we are addressing. I cannot talk about that, of course. But for me, it's a validation of the technology. It's also a validation of Alligator, and for me, it's an opportunity to build a longer term relationship with a company like Orion, which I believe is valuable for the company, and internally, it of course also sort of sharpens all our very skilled and great employees to now have input from an external expert on the biology that we are addressing. So I think it's just sort of synergistic in all ways with regards to our mission in Alligator.
Yes, and just a final question then, yeah. Also on collaboration. It strikes me as impressive that you have been able to make these partnerships at such early stages in the development. Would you agree, or is this common practice that I just have missed?
No, I think that the Orion deal is great. I think what we have done with both Aptevo and MacroGenics, these co-development agreements, I don't know if it's common practice, but I think there's been mutual recognition that both parties have come with either technology or assets and know-how that sort of could make great products. So I think it's great, and as I said, that's something that we will most likely continue to do, because it gives us an opportunity to address and leverage our technologies in a way that we cannot necessarily do for our own money continuously year on year, at least not in the stage where we are now.
I understand. Once again, Søren, thank you very much for coming. I will definitely follow your progress in the next year and beyond that.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.